Hello, my name's Simon Crafer. We're at the international circuit of Algarve, Porto Mayo, in the Tech 3 garage with the machines of Danilo Petrucci. And this week's Tech Talk is about what we're doing right now, racing into the autumn and the challenges that come with that. Look, this is a world championship, and to win it, you need to perform at all different circuits in all different conditions, you know? So from the beginning of the year, where we have cold mornings and cold evenings in Qatar, through the heat of summer, the challenges that come with that, Le Mans thrown in there, that if it's bad weather conditions can be damn cold, managing that. And then into the autumn, like now, managing the cooler temperatures in morning and evenings. So first thing you'd think of is tyres, and you're right. Tyres are one of the most important things. And I've had a good chat with Piero Taramasso, but before we give you the information, he said is, look, tyres, the higher performance they are, the smaller the working window. And I've come across that in all different championships, on all different machines. It's exactly the same. The higher the performance, the smaller the working window. For example, you've got street tyres have to work, like I've mentioned before, in the cold they work, and right through to hot afternoons they work. But when you push them to MotoGP level, to that performance, the windows get smaller and smaller. So how to manage that? I spoke to, like I said, Piero, and he was saying, how do you suggest to keep temperature in your tyres, you know? And aside from warmers, which the warmers heat the front tyre to 90 degrees, the rear to 120, that's optimum temperature. But you can lose 10 degrees just leaving pit lane. And then if you muck about, you're gonna lose some more. So you really have to, the rider has to be aware of not losing too much temperature, you know? And then basically you've got no grip when they're cold, completely cold. The performance goes up, the window's smaller, like I said, and then if they overheat, then it drops off. That's what we mean about working window. Then, if they're on the grid, the mechanics have not only warmers to keep the temperature in, they have heated blankets to stop the cold wind stealing that temperature away, make sure it doesn't. Cold mornings, they'll have engine heaters to make sure the oil is above 20 degrees, because if it's too cold, it's too thick, and the engine won't be able to pump it around quick enough, not get the oil to the right places when it first starts up. Then Piero said to keep temperature in the tyre, obviously you choose the softer compound. Softer compound means more movement. More movement creates more temperature. Then he said, we recommend raising the pressure a little, because higher pressure reduces contact patch, and the same force going through a smaller contact patch causes more temperature. And then final thing he mentioned to keep it in, which was a long agreeing with what a crew chief's told me, is more force in the tyre, putting more force in front and rear. So then speaking to crew chiefs, they mentioned, one of them put it, it's one step towards wet settings. And I went, what do you mean by that? He said, well, starters, apart from the engine heating, we need to put tape on the radiators because of big rads, really efficient, too much cooling. They haven't got thermostats, so they tape the rad up to block part of it off to keep the engine temperature up, just like you do in the rain. Then he said, they'll soften suspension settings for the cool to get more transfer, to cause more force on the tyre, more temperature. And crew chiefs also mentioned that this transfer can give rider confidence, you know, they know where it is, rather than just feeling, you know, not transferring and locking. So then I spoke to riders, and listened to riders a lot, all their debriefs, and the things they have to manage. Crew chiefs also mentioned that, like, for example, the rear tyre is easier to keep temperature in because you've got all that horsepower and control of it, how much force and where you're putting it into. And also the rear tyre is behind the engine, which creates quite a bit of heat. Not good in the summer, but the front tyre is literally out in the cold on its own, you know. And you've seen how in the high temperature races, that racing in a group is a negative thing for front tyre temperature, which creates pressure, loses grip, you know, and they can get in trouble. Well, not being out on your own, being in a group in the cold can be an advantage, keeping temperature into the tyre. And then the other thing the riders mentioned is, well, for example, Jack Miller mentioned to me at Misano, because he didn't, for whatever reason, a couple of different reasons, he didn't put enough pressure and force, creating enough temperature into turn 8 on the left side, which is the last left, until 15. So it's right. The temperature dropped out of the tyre. So when he turned left at turn 15, no temperature, no grip, down the road. That's how fine the margins are when the front tyre choice is on the limit. He was on the hard front. And later in the race, it caught Pecco as well. I hope this little insight into, you know, racing into the autumn, into the cold, was useful. And we'll see you at Valencia for the final Tech Talk of the year.